this was attached to like 3 hairs, and I'm just struggling to try to get it out. It's not budging. stories in a way that I'm hoping you will understand. But I guess most of you don't understand because my husband always tells me he doesn't understand my stories. But my best friend, yeah, so my best friend always understands all my stories. I'm trying to get this right. Thank you. Christmas. so, at least when I was growing up, it was something so prestigious. If you could afford to eat it once a month, then you are rich. So, yeah. Then now, we come from church. Continuing the story. For those who might be confused. We come from church, let's say at 1:30, 2-ish. We are super hungry. By the way, I forgot to say that breakfast, my grandma would make pancakes. My grandma would make pancakes only on Christmas and Easter. So, Christmas was really like, really a big deal for us. Did I mention that we also, like, we would get only new clothes for Christmas? Yep. We would only get new clothes for Christmas and not any other time. So, we would, my grandma, before they cut the chicken or after they cut the chicken, her and my cousin would make pancakes. She would make pancakes for the whole family, and then we would have some African tea and pancakes, and then the chicken would be cooked by her. My aunties would make chapati, knead the dough, let it sit for 1 hour, make so many chapatis. Sometimes I would help them and cover them, and then we take the food off the we used to cook on firewood. We take the chicken off the firewood, and then we shower, we go to church, we come back at 1, and that time we are super hungry. So we have one big dinner, I mean one big lunch, and we sit down and eat as much as we can. We eat, and then that's it. Basically, the day is over for us. We just chat and eat more, and then dinner. We make the fire, we warm up the food, and we eat some more. And basically, that was that. The day was done. And on 27th, 26th is Boxing Day, basically, in Africa. So, it's a public holiday. And we would, if we had more dough left for chapati, we would make more chapati. If none was left on the 25th, and then we would make some more ndengu and eat that. And yeah, sometimes we'll drink some soda, but it wasn't very common then when I was growing up to like drink soda on Christmas Day. Really, it wasn't. So if we had it, we'd drink it. If not, I would just, you know, drink some tea after dinner. Like, tea is just something that Kenyans love to drink. The Kenyans really love tea. They drink tea all the time. My auntie drinks tea like 7 times a day. You know, she's just drinking tea literally all day. Yeah, those are just some of the memories I remember. And then it's basically 30th and the 28th, 29th, 30th. And then there's a new year. In the new year, we go to church on 31st. And we sleep over there and pray the whole night until first. We come back on first in the morning. So, my grandma and my auntie didn't go to the same church. My auntie went to, I guess, a Protestant church. No, my grandma went to a Protestant church, and then my auntie went to, I guess, what do they call them? I don't know. Baptist church, something of the sort. And I would go with my auntie, and then my cousins would go with my grandcousins that we didn't see. Here's another whitehead. I guess I'm gonna squeeze this out. just